How's it going, guys? Back with another video today, and wow, what a crazy 2 weeks. I mean, I know everybody's been feeling it, and there's a lot of uncertainty in the world, but I just want to do a video right now and just kind of, you know, get everybody on track with exactly what Sarah and I are doing with our business. And if you guys are running a photography business, you don't know how to talk to your clients, you're facing cancellations, just kind of give you guys some guidance on what we're doing and how we're handling it. But first, I just kind of want to touch on this and the ways that we can use this crisis to our advantage as artists with our photography. Because the thing is like times like these can really make you question exactly what the hell you're doing, you know, and what the future is going to hold. It creates this whole level and underground, you know, foundation of uncertainty in our lives. And I just want you guys to know that that's not always a bad thing. Yes, this virus is like affecting people 100%. It's just wreaking havoc on the economy. But let's take the economy and the economics effects. Let's take them and put them aside for a second. And let's just focus on photography in terms of our artwork and the stuff that we want to do to express ourselves and say, you know, speak our voice through our photography. These things, these type of situations come up in life and they can kind of be the catalyst for some unbelievable work. Now, I know a lot of people are on quarantine and they can't leave their house. You know, they're facing not being able to work and they're scrambling around trying to make other plans. But I want you to know that you can use this time to seriously hone in on your skills. And not only that, but you can kind of develop a plan for what you want to do in terms of a body of work and, you know, creative ideas for when you get out of this, or when we all get out of this mess, because we're all in it together. Basically, this is a worldwide issue. But I'm determined to make sure that I use this time creatively and that I'm not just going to sit inside the house and just, you know, worry about the issues that are in front of me. Yes, I'm aware to them, but I'm not going to put myself on the computer in the news 100% of the time, soaked up and absorbed in all the issues, and forget about the thing that truly gives us life and gives us purpose in our lives. That's photography. That's why you guys follow this channel. I know that's why you guys are drawn to the stuff I say. It's because you know that I care about work that matters. And what I'm trying to say is let's all use this as a roadmap. Like, take this time now to internalize all the stuff that's going on and let's make sense out of it in a unique way in a type of work. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this time to put out a series of videos for you guys to help you guys learn, you know, some of the advanced techniques. I did a poll on YouTube the other day and I asked just kind of what you guys want to see from me in terms of like advanced techniques and different courses based on a specific topic. And a lot of you guys chose advanced techniques and advanced lighting. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to use this time creatively. I'm not going to sit and sulk and say, you know, why is my life different? Because you know what, guys? The ultimate thing, and I don't want to disrespect anybody who's going through a shitstorm right now, because me and Sarah, we're going through it too. We all got problems with this stuff. It's all affecting our lives. But you can't sit around and be upset and feel 100% crushed by this, because it's honestly leveled the playing field. I mean, everybody's going through it. This touches every single industry. So there are going to be massive opportunities that arise from this if we can just hang on and hold on and just, you know, move through it. So use your time. Develop an idea for a photo project. Hey, we're inside, you're quarantined, do some macro stuff. Get out your macro lens or order one offline and do a whole macro project. Commit to that every single day. You know, I mean, if you're not quarantined, you can still go out, do a photo project with, you know, stay away from people, but do like maybe like a landscape photo project or a macro outdoor project or like, a project with water or, you know, trees or whatever. Pick up your camera and remember that this can be your savior in times like this, because it helps us. The camera is a tool that helps us make sense of the world. So when we see things that aren't right or things that give us, you know, anxiety or fear or something like that, we as photographers can pick up that camera and transform all that into a message. And what I'm trying to say is I just don't want to see you guys get overwhelmed and sit inside and just, not use the time to your benefit. So even if you're not going to work on a creative photo project, you 100% can work on your skills. So that's what I'm going to try and provide for you guys while we go through this all together, really, because we're all in like a community together. We really are. Things are different now. I couldn't imagine if we were going through a quarantine like, you know, 30, 40 years ago and we didn't have the internet. Now we can kind of all like kind of help each other and, you know, lean on each other for support, especially in this photography community. This YouTube channel that I've built, I don't really think of it as just a channel. I really do think of it as a community thing here. So, you know, continue to reach out to me and continue to let me know what you guys want to see from me. But I'm going to keep building this channel with creative and informative stuff that we can all use while we're locked in and while we can't really work or move around to actually make ourselves get better at this craft. Don't forget about your camera, guys. This is the trusty D700. You guys know I've been using this a lot lately. But don't forget about this. There's a reason why we picked this camera up while we were drawn to photography in the first place. And it's a refuge. It's a way out from every shitty circumstance, no matter what's going on. It's a safe place that we can all go to and use it to create something that is helpful to not only us, but the world. And it gets us out of ourselves. So back to the original topic also. If you guys are running a photography business, I just want to tell you what we're doing. So maybe if you guys don't know how to approach these things. So Sarah and I have not actually, we haven't actually had any cancellations yet. So we're probably going to, we're definitely bracing for that. But instead of waiting around and just like, you know, just kind of being frozen and like, you know, waiting for somebody else to make the first move, we've made the first move to our clients. So everybody from, we had our next two weddings, we had two in May coming up. From May all the way through July, we've contacted all of our clients. And we were the ones who stepped out first. We didn't hear from them yet. So we said, hey, listen, we got your back. Okay. Whatever we can do to accommodate you guys, we still have we're about halfway booked for 2021 right now, maybe. Yeah, a little less than halfway booked. So we do have some open dates in 2021. We're offering those dates if anybody wants to reschedule their weddings. And we want to let them know we're here to help you guys, to plan this, to walk through this with them. We're not just going to, you know, say, hey, we got your deposit, you know, and see you later if we can't do your wedding. It's, no, what can we do for you? So we're reaching out to these people and being proactive. And what we've found is a lot of these people haven't even heard from their venues yet. I mean, they're still kind of like, I think a lot of these venues are still kind of traumatized and they're like just hoping that it's going to go away and everything's going to go back to normal in like a month. I personally don't believe that. I think that we're going to be facing cancellations, you know, maybe around July, maybe even into August. So we're preparing for, we're being proactive. We're telling all these people, hey, listen, if you want to reschedule, let's find dates. And if you don't, you want to kind of play it by ear, just let us know and keep us in the loop. But talk to your other vendors and make sure that they're communicating with you. Don't just send one email and then let them ignore you. Make sure you're reaching back out to them and developing a plan now. Because we do have to plan for this stuff. This is an existential, you know, event, an act of God, if you want to say that. And it's affecting everybody. So we've found that reaching out now, we're actually the first vendors, and it makes us look very good, and it makes our clients actually trust us because we're the ones who are taking the bull by the horns and saying, hey, like, let's develop a plan here. We're not going to leave you guys high and dry. We're not just going to say, you know, hey, you know, thanks for the deposit. We're gone. We're going to help you guys reschedule. We're going to help everybody get through this together. And I think if you really focus, guys, instead of getting too deep into the news, being glued to the television, being glued to the phone, looking at all the incoming notifications about this, you know, new case here, this new case here, this person, you know, focus on what's ahead of you, focus on the things that need to get done, and focus on your photography. Because I promise you that eventually this thing will be over. We're all going to get through this, and we're going to come out stronger, but also there's going to be massive opportunities on the other side. And if you establish yourself now as the photographer or as the vendor or the person who reached out first, who was really helpful and guided people in, that's only going to solidify you as a really, really good person to hire once this whole shit show is over. So I really hope this was helpful to you guys. And like I said, I'm going to be working on, Sarah and I both going to be working on some, advanced technique stuff. We're going to be releasing that. Thank you to all the people who have donated, joined as members on the channel, Patreon, donations, things like that. You guys have been freaking awesome. I'm really going to work hard to make this a community and bring us all through this as much as we can. We can all kind of lean on each other until this whole mess is over. So hopefully you guys find this informative. And until the next video, my friends.